little flower is arguably the most beloved modern saint. Her teachings are timeless lessons on how to love God with one's whole heart in the simple pattern of our daily life. As she herself says, "In my little way, everything is most ordinary. Everything I do must be within the reach of other little souls too." She teaches us how to suffer in Him, with Him, and through Him. Saint Little Flower knew her limitations, her littleness, and she never aspired to ascend the heights of perfection, just like great saints, by leading such an ascetic life. In her quest for holiness, she discovered that her vocation is love. To respond to the great love God the Father has lavished upon her, she tried to please Him by strewing flowers of sacrifices, acts of mortification, and by small deeds of love. She explained what she has meant by mortification. She says, "When I speak of mortification, I don't mean the kind of penance practiced by saints. There are great souls who practiced every sort of mortification from childhood. But I am not like any of them. All I did was to break my self-will, check a hasty reply, and do little kindness without making a fuss about them, and lots of small things." Saint Little Flower confesses that even as a child, she was the mistress of her self-will. She never wanted to bow her head before anyone, even to her sweet mother. But her mother certifies that even at the age of 3, she started to fight against, to conquer her will and subdue it to the will of Jesus. She learned the value of small acts of self-mortification from the time she was young. Here is one such event from her autobiography. "I was 10 years old the day my father told Celine he was going to let her have lessons in painting. I envied her. Then Papa said to me, 'And you, my little queen, would it give you pleasure too to learn drawing?' I was just going to respond with a very gladsome yes when Mary said that I had not the same taste for it as Celine. At once she gained the day. And I, thinking that here was some good opportunity of offering grand sacrifice to Jesus, said not a word." After entering the cloistered Carmel, Saint Little Therese was in constant fight to mortify herself. She knew self-mortification is the means to self-mastery. In the convent laundry of Lisieux, she worked opposite to a sister who would splash her with dirty water. She refrained from her inclinations to draw back to wipe her face to show the sister how much this annoyed her. This may seem very small, but the self-will is denied and curbed in small things as in great things, and sometimes more so when things go against the grain. Throughout her autobiography, one can find thousands of such instances. And what is most beautiful in these all is that she does them all with a smile. She says, "To write books of devotion, to compose the most sublime poetry is of less worth than the least act of renunciation." Saint Therese told her novices, "We must do all in our power to give without counting the cost. We must deny ourselves constantly. We must prove our love to Him. So let us also awake to grab the opportunity that come on our way to break our self-will, deny ourselves, and to offer before Him flowers of sacrifices as Saint Little Therese did."
Thank you. Yeah.